Hey guys, welcome back. My name is Veena Asmanov and today I'm sharing a recipe for hot crust buns. It's almost Easter, so time to make hot crust buns. If you've enjoyed all my bread recipes so far, you're going to love this one as well. It's a very simple and easy recipe. I'm kneading the dough by hand, but you can use a stand mixer. Let's get started.
I'm going to start by soaking the raisins. Soaking the raisins will help make sure that the raisins are already moist and they don't take any moisture from the dough. That way we will have a nice soft moist bread and not dry bread. Now I've got warm milk and some yeast. It is very important that the milk is warm, about 110 degrees Fahrenheit, so that the yeast does not die. I've given that a mix. I'm going to add in the 2 eggs. Don't worry about the list of ingredients, it will be below this video as well as on the blog. My blog has a very detailed recipe with step-by-step pictures as well as all the necessary FAQ, whatever you may need to ask. Okay, I highly recommend going to my blog. I've got sugar because this is the sweet dough. You can reduce the sugar by almost half if you need. Now you want to make sure you give all this a good mix. And I've got some melted butter. In my previous video for hot crust buns, I showed you how to do, I use room temperature butter. In this one, we're going to try something different. I've added salt to the flour and now I'm going to add the yeast mixture. I'm going to make sure I give it a good mix so that all the sugar is inside and not at the bottom of my cup. Okay, I'm going to smooth it out with a wooden spoon first and then use a pen scraper to remove as much as I can onto a flat surface. Now you can use a stand mixer. I'm doing this on a workboard with my hands and this will take about 5 minutes to knead by hand, about 3 minutes in a stand mixer. What's important is not the time but the consistency of the dough. You want a soft, smooth, silky dough so that when you press your 2 fingers into it, you kind of bounce back. So I'll show you that in a minute, what I mean by that. Now you want to knead this with the heel of your hand. Well, you can see sometimes I do this in a stand mixer, but you see how smooth and soft that dough is? That's what you're looking for. It will be slightly sticky, but not very sticky. And it should spring back. And when I mean by that, you see that I press my 2 fingers inside, it comes out. Comes up again. I'm going to put some oil in my bowl. I'm going to just oil the bowl so that I can put this dough to rest for about 60 minutes. Okay, until it's almost double in size. I'm going to cover it with a cloth or a cling wrap and put it aside. Well, after 60 minutes, the dough will be almost double in size. You want to take it out onto a lightly flat surface. You do not need too much of flour at this point. And I'm going to add the soaked raisins and my cranberries. I've got some plump cranberries that are semi-dried, so I haven't soaked those, but you can soak those as well. And I'm going to just knead that in just a little bit so it's all over the dough and not in one place. Okay, now I'm going to cut this dough, divide this dough so that we can make equal portions. I'm going to start by making 4 first. And then I'm going to divide each one into 3 each so that way I have 12. Now as I told you in the previous video as well, I want to make sure that most of the fruits are inside so that then they don't get burned, because in the oven sometimes if the fruits are sticking out they tend to get burned very badly. So you want to make sure that the fruits are kind of more or less, you can have a few outside but not too many, because otherwise you'll have too many burnt ones. And you want to tuck all the seams in so you can have as smooth as you can a bowl. Okay. The best way to get a nice smooth bowl would be to actually roll the dough between your palms, in your palms, under your palms, on a non-flat surface. I usually prefer to do it by hand, but again, you don't have to do it by hand. I put it on a baking tray and making sure that I have enough space for them to rise. Again, I'm going to cover this and leave it to rise for another 30 minutes. And they won't be double in size, but somewhere 30 minutes is a good guide. Now, because we are not making an a flour crust, we're going to bake these first and then make an icing crust. If you want to do the flour crust, you can see my previous video where I showed how to put the flour crust before you bake the dough. Now, I'm going to brush this with a nice egg wash and bake them for about 20 to 25 minutes. And you can see over here, they're nicely baked. I'm brushing them with some melted butter. Well, actually, it's just regular butter and it's melting on the warm dough. Bread. Okay. I'm going to cool these off completely. Now, this is very important. You want to make sure that you cool these off completely before you do the icing. This is milk and powdered sugar. I'm just going to give it a good mix. And you want a piping consistency, a thick piping consistency. You see this one? This is a good consistency. You don't want it too flowing, but when it flows, okay? And you don't want too much because you're just making a crust on each one. So I've got about 2 tablespoons worth of this. And don't worry, the list of ingredients is below this video as well as on my blog, so you can get. And you can see I placed the dough of breads on a wire rack so that any spillage will kind of go down, and I'm just making lines across, as simple as that. I did use a piping bag, but I've not used any piping nozzle. I just got a small tip at the end, and that's all. I'm going to let these dry, but as you can see, I didn't want to miss out on you seeing the inside, so I'm actually opening one without drying it out.
Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And of course, subscribe and hit the notification bell for more videos from me every week. I will see you on the next video. Bye-bye for now. Thank you so much for joining me.